cash generating unit. Cash generating unit. Cash generating unit is the smallest, is an independent, is the smallest identifiable group of assets in which an independent cash flow can be identified or measured. Cash generating unit is the smallest identifiable group of assets in which an independent cash flows can be identified or measured. I repeat, cash generating unit is the smallest identifiable group of assets in which an independent cash flows can be identified or measured. For a cash generating unit to be for a group of assets to be charged to the following procedures have to be followed. So anytime you are given a group of assets, we are going to follow the following procedures in allocating the impairment loss among the group of assets. Number one, the first thing is that no impairment loss should be charged to monetary assets. Anytime you have monetary assets, such as the trade receivables, the cash we have, and others. So when you have them, don't charge an impairment loss to them. They should not be impaired. Number two, you allocate maximum impairment loss to goodwill. Allocate maximum impairment loss to goodwill. That is to the extent to which that goodwill can accommodate. You allocate the maximum impairment loss to goodwill. Number two, we have specific assets. So you charge the impairment loss to specific assets. That is where you have the specific impairment or specific asset. That impairment loss that is attributable to that specific asset is the amount of impairment loss that that specific asset should receive. Number four, then other assets. You allocate the impairment loss on plural basis. You allocate the impairment loss on plural basis. I think that the first thing is that for monetary assets, you should not impair them. Number two, specific assets. We receive the impairment loss to the tune of that amount that is attributable to that specific asset. Number three, you allocate the maximum impairment loss to goodwill. Then you allocate the remaining impairment loss on pro rata basis. So we therefore want to take a work example. Work example. On 1st January 2011, Multiplex acquires Steel Days, a company that operates a scenic railway along the coast of a popular tourist area. The summarized statement of financial position as peer values of Steel Days on 1st January 2010 reflecting the terms of the acquisition was, you are given goodwill, you are given the operating license, then you have the property, train stations, and land. Then you have racetrack and coaches. Then you have two steam engines. Then you have purchase consideration. The operating license is for 10 years. It was renamed on 1st of January 2011. By the Transport Authority and is stated at the cost of its renewal. The carrying values of the property are racetrack and coaches are based on their value in use. The engines are valued at their net selling prices on 1st of February 2011. the boiler of one of the steam engines exploded, completely destroying the whole engine. Fortunately, no one was injured, but the engine was beyond repair. Due to its age, a replacement could not be obtained because of the reduced passenger capacity. The estimated value in use of the whole of the business after the accident was assessed as $2 million. Passenger number after the accident were below expectations, even allowing for the reduced capacity. A market research report concluded that tourists were not using the railway because of their fear of a similar accident occurring to the remaining engine. In the light of this, the value in use of the business was reassessed on 31st March 2007 at $1.8 million. On this day, Multiplex received an offer of $900,000. In respect of the operating license, it is transferable. The realizable value of the net asset has not changed significantly. Required. Calculate the carrying value of the assets of Steam Day in Multiplex consolidated statement of financial position at February 20 and 31st March 2000 after recognizing the impairment loss. Now, we want to allocate the impairment loss. We have Multiplex. So we have allocation of impairment loss. We have for February 20 and then 31st March 2000. This is 1st of February 2000 and 31st March 2000. Then we have 31st March 2000. This is 1st February 2000. March 2000. Then we have the value of the assets as a liability. Then we have impairment loss. Then we have the carrying amount. Let me just have value of the assets. Value of the assets as 1st of February 2000. Then we have the end of February, that is 20. Then we also have impairment loss. Then the value of the assets were given as a first of that time. Okay, this will be 1st of February 20x0. We have impairment loss, then we have value of the asset. Assets, that is at the beginning of the period, which is 1st of January 2000.
Impairment loss of 1 million. That is the difference between this and this.
you have charged the specific impairment of 500 to steel engine. Then after specific impairment, we said you should allocate maximum impairment to goodwill. So now, out of 1,500 has been allocated to steel engine, then you will be left with 500. Then, and goodwill is 200. That means you are going to allocate that 200 to goodwill. Goodwill will be completely written off. Then the steam engines will be left with a balance of 500. At least 1,000 minus 500, that will be 500. For goodwill, 200 and 200 will be needed. That is as a fair. Passenger numbers after the accident were below expectation. Even allowing this information, this paragraph, the release will tell you. Passenger numbers after the accident were below expectation. Even allowing for the reduced capacity. The market research report concluded that Paris were not using the railway because of their fear of a similar accident, according to the remaining engine. In the light of this, the valuing use of the diesel was reassessed on 31st March 2018. That is the valuing use. As at 31st of March 2018, the valuing use becomes 1.8 million. Remember, as at February ending, it was 2 million. It has now increased to 1.8 million as at 31st of March. That means there is a further impairment loss of 200. Further impairment of 200. Now, how will you now? Now, if you read further, on this day, Multiplex received an offer of 900,000 in respect of the operating license. That means the value of operating license now changed to 900 as at that date. Now, you have given 500 to steam engine and 200 to goodwill. Then this will be total 700. The damage you have charged or allocated so far, then you will be left with $300. That is, if you subtract the 700 from 1,000, you will be left with 300. The remaining 300 will now be shared between other assets on pro rata basis. So to share it now, you are going to sum up the value of the other assets you have here. 1,200 plus 300 plus 300. That will be, this is 1,518. Other asset will be 1,8. Now, as I said, we want to allocate the remaining impairment of 300 to other assets. We have operating license. The first asset is operating license. The second one is property trade. Property, train, station. The third one is rail track and goods. Rail, track, and coaches.
The 700 between
goodwill and steam engine. The balance of 300 will now be shared on pro rata basis, 1900. This one will be 300 out of 1/8 times 300. This one too will be 300 out of 1/8 times 300. So, we get the amount that will be charged as impairment to other assets. So, we have 300. This one will give us 200. This one will give us 50. This one too will be 50. So you now put it here. 200 for operating license, 50 for proxy train station, and 50 for rail, track, and coaches. So the recoverable amount now, as I've heard now, so we have 1,200 minus 200 will be 1,000. Then 300 minus 50 will be 250. Then 300 minus 52 will be 250. If you sum up these, it will give us 2,000. Now, between February and March, the value of operating license, the recoverable value of the operating license is now 900. And it was 1,000 before. That means there is a further impairment of 100. Now, for the steam engine, there is no further impairment, so you have need. And the operating license, now the recoverable value of the operating license is now 900. Since there are no further impairments of steam engine, so you will be having 500. And the recoverable amount of the steam engine. Then that means the remaining impairment of 100 will be allocated between these two assets. The remaining impairment will be allocated between the property and rail track. So, the properties and the rail track. So, we have property, which is 250. The rail track, which is 250 as well. Total 500. Then the property will receive 250 out of 500 times that 100. Then you will have it. You will be left with 50. While rate track 2 will be 250 out of 500 times 100, which is 50. So you give the 50 to properties, and then you also give 50 to rail track. Then you will have a balance of 200 and the 200 as well. So if you sum up this, then you give us 1,800. That is the procedures of allocating the impairment loss to cash.